गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी डिस्कस एक्सपेरिमेंट नंबर 17 ऑन पेज नंबर 125. एम ऑफ आवर टुडे एक्सपेरिमेंट इज टू ड्रॉ द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक कर्व ऑफ अ ज़ीनर डायोड एंड टू डिटरमाइन इट्स रिवर्स ब्रेकडाउन वोल्टेज. नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नो अबाउट द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ड. कैरेक्टरिस्टिक मीन्स the relation between current and voltage. So we have to discuss here, or we have to find this relation between current and voltage for Zener diode. In 14th chapter we will discuss about this Zener diode in detail. Actually Zener diode is nothing but a one kind of PN junction diode in reverse connection. So now see the apparatus. The apparatus is PN junction Zener diode. It is like a box as shown here to you in video. So in video you observe that one switch is there. This switch is for on and off. Here one switch is there for forward connection and for reverse connection. So if you want to study forward connection, then keep your switch in upward direction, and for reverse connection, reverse characteristic, then keep it in downward direction. Same way this key is for current. Here it is voltage, voltmeter is given to you. Forward and reverse, we have to study a reverse characteristic, so adjust your key at reverse position. Now you observe that in voltmeter there are two type of calibration is given to you, upper and lower. So upper and lower both is in volt. So here you observe that in upper side 0 to 0.2, 0.4 and last is 1, and on upper scale here it is 0 to 10 volt. Lower scale is important for us, so just find out the list count of this scale. So between 0 to 2 there are 10 divisions, so value of one division is 0.2 volt. Now see, here it is your ammeter. Ammeter also it is in milliampere. Upper scale and lower scale. Lower scale is important for us. So just find out the list count of this apparatus. So between 0 to 1 there are 10 division. So value of one division is equal to 0.1 milliampere. Now what we have to do? In Ohm's law you have already studied relation between voltage and current. Same thing we have to study here. In Ohm's law you change the voltage by using your rheostat. While in this Zener diode you can change your voltage by using a knob which is given to you on your board. With the help of this knob you can change the value of voltage, and according to voltage you can note down the reading for current. So before taking reading, just we study here the circuit diagram on page number 126. See, this is the symbol of PN junction diode, your Zener diode. This is the symbol for Zener diode. You know that if you want to measure current, then you have to connect your current measuring instrument in series with this apparatus. So I connect a current measuring instrument, that is ammeter, in series. We want to measure voltage also, and you know that for voltage you have to connect your voltage measuring instrument parallel to your apparatus. So voltage, voltmeter is parallel to our Zener diode. I want to study the relation between current and voltage, so definitely adjust voltage and note down the reading for current. So for this I have to change the voltage. So this rheostat or knob is used here. See, in your circuit with the help of this knob you can change your voltage, and in this circuit this rheostat symbol is given to you. And for current and measure, for measure passing the current, battery as well as key is required. So here variable battery and key is given to you. So this is the circuit diagram for your Zener diode. See, in exam you have to draw this circuit diagram first, so you have to prepare this circuit diagram. Okay, so now we come to our experiment, how to take readings. So now see here, in observation table only two columns are there. One is voltmeter reading and another is your ammeter reading. See, in your book it is given to you microampere, but our apparatus we can measure current in order of milliampere. So this practical is similar to now your Ohm's law. Adjust your voltage and note down the reading. But before starting our reading, you can observe the characteristic, theoretical characteristic of Zener diode. So on x-axis voltage is there, and on y-axis current is there, and current is in milliampere. Okay, so now from this graph, if you draw a graph of V versus I, then you observe that if you increase your voltage, it doesn't make any difference in your ammeter reading. After some particular voltage, your current starts to increase, and it increases rapidly. So the curve of V versus I is like this way. So definitely from this graph you get the idea that only 4 to 5 readings are important for you. For starting value of 0 volt, the current is nearly 0. Okay, so now we start our experiment, and how to write readings I will explain you. So for this, first of all, switch on your apparatus. Adjust all these keys on reverse mode for current, for voltage, and for your diode also. So all keys are at reverse mode. So now see, if I move this knob, in Ohm's law we change the voltage by using rheostat, while in this experiment we can change our voltage by using this knob. Rheostat is already inbuilt. So now just see, you have to concentrate on lower scale, both ammeter as well as voltmeter. So now just adjust your voltmeter at 0 volt, note down the reading for current. So definitely it is also at 0. So note down this reading in your observation table. Voltmeter reading is 0 volt and ammeter reading is also 0 volt. Now adjust it at 1 volt, because we know that your current is not increases. So your difference is high, means more difference, take reading for more difference. So adjust it at 1 volt, you observe that the reading of your current is 0, so just write down 0. Adjust it at 2 volt, definitely your current is 0, 3 volt also it is 0, 4 volt it is also 0, 5 volt is 0, 6 volt is also 0. Now see, just concentrate, when you move your knob this time, just concentrate on your ammeter. So you observe that after 6 volt your current starts to increase. See, so adjust your current at 0.1 milliampere, and at that time your voltage is 7 volt. Then just take a difference of only one division, so it is 7.2, it is also on 0.1, it is 7.4, it is at 0.5. Okay, then 7.6, it is nearer to 4.7. Now if you increase the voltage, then definitely your ammeter pointer cross the scale. So your practical is over. So now here we observe that your current starts to increase for a particular value of voltage. This voltage is known as breakdown voltage. So in this experiment you have to find your breakdown voltage with the help of your graph. See, now draw the graph for your voltage versus current like this way. You have only 3 or 4 readings. So the current increases rapidly at a particular voltage, and this voltage is known as breakdown voltage. So with the help of graph, you can easily find your answer for breakdown voltage. This is your result. Okay, I hope you understand it properly. When you do this experiment, then you can easily get idea about this practical in detail. Okay, thank you.